गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन एंड ओम शांति. टुडे इज 3/9/2024 बाबा साकार वर्जन. इट इज मॉर्निंग मुरली. ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन. एसेंस ऑफ टुडेज मुरली. बाबा सेड स्वीट चिल्ड्रन यू मस्ट नॉट लव एनी इम्प्योर बॉडीली बींग्स बिकॉज यू आर गोइंग टू द प्योर वर्ल्ड. सो हैव लव फॉर वन The one father, only one father is ocean of purity and love, and we are going in the pure world. That's why Baba says he can only make us pure, and that too with love. That's why we have to remember him only. Question from today's Murli: What should you not get fed up with and why? Baba is giving very good answer. You must not get fed up even slightly with those old bodies of yours. Why? Because those bodies are very, very valuable. Your soul sit in those bodies and win a very big lottery by remembering the Father. If you still in remembrance of the Father, you continue to receive the nourishment of happiness. Baba says, though it is a old body, though it is an unhealthy body, but with this body we are studying, we are becoming Baba, and with the power of Baba we are making ourselves pure, and we are earning, Baba says, so many treasures, that is subtle treasures in Brahmin life. So that's a big lottery. Baba says you are becoming multi-millionaires. That's why this body is very, very valuable, and because we are getting everything from Baba says that is the nourishment of happiness. Om Shanti. Baba says, sweetest spiritual children, you are now resident of the far away land, and you will then become passengers going to the far away land. So Baba is reminding us, we have come from far away to pay the part in this corporeal world, and again we have to go away, that is a far away land. So we are souls and we are now making efforts to go to a land very far away. Only you children know that you are souls and resident of the far away land. You call out to the Father who reside in the far away land, come and take us to the far away land too, because nobody can take us back to our faraway land, that is our home. Now the Father who resides in the faraway land is taking you children back there. You are spiritual passengers because you are with those bodies. So Baba has given very big title today, spiritual passengers. Now passengers who travel from here and there. So in the corporeal world, soul traveled with the body, but Baba says body cannot travel. So body cannot be given this title passenger. Only spirit is traveling. So it is the spirit that does the traveling. The body will be left here and the spirit will do the traveling. Where will you souls go? To your spiritual world. Because spirit will go to his own world. So Baba says spirit will travel without body now. Our destination is there. So this is a physical world and that is a spiritual world. The Father has explained to you children, you now have to return to the home from where you came to play your parts. This is a very big stage. And this, Baba says, this earth is a very big stage where we are playing our role. Everyone has to act and perform their parts on the stage and then return home. You can only go back when the play is over. So Baba says you are now sitting here and your intellect yoga is with your home and the kingdom. Remember this very firmly, because it is remembered that your final thoughts lead to you to your destination. So that is the proverb Baba says. Antamati Sogati. That's why Baba says where we have to go, that we have to remember. Then only we can remember who is taking us there, means at our home and in the new world, making us capable of going in the new world. That's why last time Baba says, whomever you will remember, you will reach there. That will be our destination. You are now studying here and you know that God, Shiv Baba, is teaching you. God cannot teach you at any time other than except at this most auspicious confluence age. So throughout this cycle, Baba is coming at the end, that is the confluence of old world and new world. So only once in the whole 5,000 years does the Father, this act Baba is doing only, Baba says, once in 5,000 years. Incorporeal God come and teach you. You have this firm faith. The study is so easy. You now have to return home. The whole world loves that home. And Baba says, all the souls of all religions, those who are in the role now, Baba says, they also love their home. Everyone wants to go to the land of liberation, but they don't understand the meaning of that. Some say liberation, some say, so you just make us free from all what we did. So all religion, they will just call it with different names. So look what people's intellects are like at this time and look what your intellects have now become. Baba says there is such a vast difference. You have clean intellects, number-wise, according to your efforts. You have a very good knowledge of the beginning, middle, make efforts and definitely become Narayana from an ordinary human. From here, you will first go to your home, and so you have to go in happiness. Just as in the golden age, the deities sell their bodies and take others in happiness, in the same way, you have to sell those old bodies in happiness. Because we have to go home, we have to leave this body. That with that body, we were for 63 births. So Baba is just reminding that just like deities sell their body, you have to sell your old body, right? That too in happiness. You must not get fed up with them because they are very valuable bodies. It is through those bodies that you souls win a lottery from the Father. Until we become pure, we cannot go back home. Only when you continue to remember the Father with the power of yoga will your burdens of sins be removed. Our house is a house that is the land of pure energy because our Father, the highest energy is residing there. So we have also to make ourselves pure. Otherwise, there will have be a lot of punishment. Baba will make us pure if we will not become pure ourselves. So you definitely have to become pure. In worldly relationship, if a child does some dirty, impure act, then because he has become impure against the law, his father, out of anger, could even beat him with a stick. Just Baba is giving that example. But our this father of soul, he is not taking stick, but he will just saw big eyes. Baba says, if someone loves another against the law, the parents do not like that. This unlimited father says, you children don't have to live here any longer. We allowed Maya up till now, that Baba doesn't like it. Baba says, you now have to go to the new world. No vicious impure beings exist there. Only the one purifier father comes and makes us pure like that. So Baba says, like him, he is making us pure. The father himself says, my birth is divine and unique. So how Baba is coming? Baba is then today explaining, other souls cannot enter a body in the way that I do. So Baba is entering in the body of another human being. He don't have his own body. He is not taking birth with his body. So that is the difference. Baba says, although the souls of the founders of the religion also enter a body, that is a different matter. I come to take everyone back. They come down from up above to play their parts. I tell you how you first go to the new world and I then come and take everyone back with him. Baba says, though the founder of the religions, they are also entering another body like me only, but what is the difference? Baba says, they will establish the religion and they will leave the body and they will again come in the part with their own body and they will pull the souls of their religion after him. So Baba doesn't do this act. Baba says, I once take the body, makes the impure souls pure, and I take everybody them with me back to home. That founder of the religion, they don't take the souls of their religion back to home. That is the difference. Then Baba says,
Om Chandi, sister, every sentence you explained, so you read them really, please.
Okay, explanation not required.
Yeah.
Okay. No stores in that golden age, new world. The father comes in the midst of storks and makes you into swans. You have now become swans. You select pearls. You will not receive these wells in the golden age. You are now picking up these wells of knowledge and becoming swans. The father sits here and explains how you become swans from storks. He is now making you into swans. Deities are called swans and devils are called storks. You now enable people to renounce rubbish and make them select pearls. You alone are called multi-million times fortunate. There are multi-millions at every step. Sri Baba does not have fit that he could have multi-millions. He makes you multi-millions times fortunate. The father says, I have come to make you masters of the world. All of these things have to be understood very clearly. People understand that there was heaven, but they don't know when it existed or how it will exist again. You children have now been enlightened. All of those people are in darkness. They don't know when or how Lakshmi and Narayana became the masters of the world. It is a matter of 5,000 years. The father sits here and explains to you, just as you come to play your part, so I too come in the same way. You invite me and say, oh Baba, come and make us impure ones pure. You would never say this to anyone else. You would not even say to the founder of your religion, come and make us all pure. Neither Christ nor Buddha would be called the purifier. A guru is one who grants salvation. Those people, means founder of the religions, come down here and then everyone has to follow them down. Only the one father, the immortal image, is the one who shows you the way back home and grants everyone salvation. In fact, the word Satguru is right. The Sikhs speak words that are more right than the words you speak. They say very loudly, Satguru, the immortal one. They chant this very loudly. They say the Satguru is the immortal image. If there were no image, how could he be the Satguru and how could he grant everyone salvation? That Sadguru comes and he himself gives his own introduction. I do not take birth in the way that you do. Everywhere else, it is bodily beings who sit and relate knowledge, whereas the bodiless spiritual father sits here and explains to you. There is the difference of day and night. Whatever people do at this time, it is wrong, because they follow the dictates of Ravan. There are the five vices in each one. It is now the kingdom of Ravan. The father sits here and explains these things to you in detail. Otherwise, how would you know about the cycle of the whole world? You should know how this cycle turns. You don't ask Baba to explain it to you. The father continues to explain by himself without your asking him. You don't need to ask a single question. God is the father. The father's duty is to tell you everything by himself and to do everything by himself. A father has his children. admitted into a school by himself, he makes them go to work and tell them to leave everything after the age of 60 and just remember God, sing devotional songs, read the Vedas and scriptures, and perform worship. You have been worshippers for half a cycle and are now becoming worthy of worship for half a cycle. It is explained to you so easily how you can become pure. Then worshipping is stopped completely. All of these people are performing worship. All of those people are performing worship, whereas you are receiving this knowledge. They are in the night, whereas you are going into the day, that is to heaven. It is written in the Gita, Manmana Bhava, this word is very known well. Those who study the Gita can understand this. What is written is very easy. People have been studying the Gita all their lives, but they haven't understood anything. That same God of the Gita now sits here and teaches you. You then become pure from impure. We know here the Gita from God and we can relate it to others. We now hear the Gita from God and we then relate it to others and become pure. There are the Father's elevated versions. This is that same easy Raj Yoga. People are drowning so much in blind faith that they don't even listen to you. According to the drama, only when their fortune opens, can they come to you. None of those of other religions have the fortune that you have. The Father has explained this deity religion of yours is one that gives a lot of happiness. You also understand that what the Father says is right. Baba says in the scriptures, they have also shown Kans, Ravans, etc. there. No one knows about the happiness there. Although they worship the deities, nothing sits in their intellects. The Father now says, children, do you remember me? Have you ever heard a father saying to his children that remember me? Does a worldly father ever ask you to make efforts to remember him? The unlimited Father sits here and explains to you. By knowing the beginning, middle, and end of the whole world, you become rulers of the globe. First of all, you will go home and then go down there as actors. Now, no one would be able to tell whether someone is a new soul or an old soul. New souls will definitely become well-known. Even now, look how well-known some are. So many human beings come. So many people come unexpectedly. There is that impact. Baba too comes in this one unexpectedly, and so there is that impact. When new souls come here, is an impact on the old souls too. When the branches and twigs continue to emerge, there is their praise. No one knows why they are so famous. Because of being new souls, there is attraction in them. Look how many false gods there are now. That is why it is remembered, the boat of truth may rock, but it will not sink. Many storms come because God is the boatman. Children also fluctuate and the boat is affected by many storms. Many go to other spiritual gatherings, but there is no question of storm, etc. there. Here, there are so many assaults on innocent women. Nevertheless, establishment definitely has to take place. The Father sits here and explains, O souls, you have become such sharp thorns. When you become a thorn and prick others, you too are pricked. You receive a response to everything you do. There isn't anything dirty there that would cause sorrow. That is why it is called heaven. People speak of heaven and hell, but they don't understand anything. They say so and so has gone to heaven. In fact, it is wrong to say that. The incorporeal world cannot be called heaven. That is a land of liberation. Then Baba says, they then say that that person has gone to heaven. You now know that the land of liberation is the home of souls, just as there is a home here. On the path of devotion, those who are wealthy have big temples built. Look how the temple to Shiva was built. They also built temples to Lakshmi and Narayana, and there are so many real jewels, etc. There is a lot of wealth there. Now all have become false. Previously, you used to wear so much real jewelry. Now, because they are afraid of the government, people hide real jewelry away and wear artificial jewelry. There is nothing but the truth. There is nothing false there. Here, even though they have real jewelry, they hide it day by day. Baba says gold continue to become more and more expensive. There it is heaven. You receive everything new. In the new world, everything is new, and there is an abundance of wealth. Now, look how everything has become so expensive. All the secrets of the incorporeal world onwards have been explained to you. Who else, Baba says, other than the Father would tell you the secret of the incorporeal world? You then also have to become teachers. You may live at home with your families, but lotus. If you make others similar to yourself, you can claim a very high status. You can claim a higher status than those who live here. It is Baba says number wise. While living outside means at home, not at a center, you can still be threaded in the rosary. Just take the week's course and then go abroad or anywhere. The whole world has to receive the message. The Father has come and simply says, constantly remember me alone. That Father is the liberator and the guide. If you go there, you will become well known through the newspapers. Others will also find this very easy. The soul and the body are two separate things. A mind and an intellect are in each soul, whereas the body is non-living. It is the soul that becomes an actor. It is the soul that has the speciality, and so you now have to remember the Father. Those who live here don't remember him as much as those who live outside do. Those who remember him a lot and continue to make others similar to themselves, who continue to change thorns into flowers, claim a high status. You understand that previously you too were thorns. The Father has now issued an ordinance. Jealousy is the greatest enemy. Conquer it and you will become the conquerors of the world. However, no one understands anything simply from those written words. The Father has now explained everything. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long-lost and now-found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to you spiritual children, and we spiritual children with love say namaste to our spiritual father. Meethe meethe sikilade bachcho prati maat pita baap dada ka yaad pyar aur good morning. Ruhani baap ki ruhani bachcho ko namaste. Hum ruhani bachcho ki ruhani maat pita baap dada ko yaad pyar good morning aur namaste. Shukriya baba. So essence for dharana from today's murli, point number one. Become swans who constantly select jewels of knowledge. Only select the pearls and leave the rubbish. Earn an income of multi-millions at every step and become multi-millions times fortunate. Second point, in order to claim a high status, become a teacher and serve many others. Become as pure as a lotus and make others similar to yourself. Change thorns into flowers. Now, blessing for today, may you be merciful and finish any upheaval of mine and yours by letting your feelings of mercy immerse. The explanation, from time to time, many souls are caught up in waves of sorrow. When there is the slightest upheaval of nature, when there are calamities, very many souls suffer and ask for mercy. When you hear the call of such souls, let your feelings of mercy immerse. Adopt your worthy of worship, merciful form. Make yourself complete and this world of sorrow will finish. Now spread waves of good wishes for transformation at a fast speed and the upheaval of mine and yours will finish. Slogan for today, instead of trying to break a mountain of problems with a hammer of wasteful thoughts, take a high jump across that mountain. So thank you very much. You will remember Baba.